naming of an organic compound. Because of the diversity in the nature of an organic compound, it is very difficult for us to remember the name of a compound unless we have a systematic procedure. For example, in inorganic compounds, say H2SO4, with that formula, except sulfuric acid, no other compound is possible to exist. So we can name it as sulfuric acid, and it is easy for us to remember that name easily. But in the case of organic compounds, it is not so. With same molecular formula, there are variety of compounds because of the nature of carbon, which we have studied in the earlier classes, that is isomerism. Because of that unique property, with same molecular formula, there are varieties of compounds with different physical and chemical properties are possible to exist. So, here we required a special procedure to name an organic compound, because the number of organic compounds it's a huge number. With a slight difference, we can have one compound with entirely different compounds, with entirely different properties. We have so many compounds with same molecular formulas. For that purpose, IUPAC, it's an International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. It was an organization which gives some guidelines for naming an organic compound. The whole world, now we are following the guidelines that was given by this organization. So this we call it as IUPAC nomenclature, or IUPAC system of naming of an organic compound. In IUPAC system, in the name of an organic compound, we have some important parts. Let us discuss in detail about those parts. The important parts in the name of an organic compound are: one is root word, and following to the root word we have primary suffix, then secondary suffix, and here we have a prefix. These are the important parts. One, this is first one, this is root word, and second part is primary suffix, secondary suffix, and prefix. These are the four important parts in the name of an organic compound. Now let us discuss each of this part in detail. Now root word. Root word will give us the number of carbon atoms that was present in a given compound. The root word will based on the number of compounds that are present in the given organic compound, particularly in the main chain of the organic compound. With the help of this root word, we'll have an idea about the structure of that organic compound and the number of carbon atoms that were present in it. So this root word will based on the number of carbon atoms. If number of carbon atoms is 1, the root word will be meth. If number of carbon atoms are 2, root word is eth. Number of carbon atoms are 3. Probe. Number of carbon atoms are 4. Butte. Number of carbon atoms are 5. Pent. If number of carbon atoms are 6, hex. Number of carbon atoms are 7, hept. 8. If number of carbon atoms are 8, oct. If number of carbon atoms are 9, nova, deca, and so on. So this is the root word which gives us the information regarding the number of carbon atoms that were present in a main chain. Let us discuss about chain later. After introducing all these terms, I'll explain you what is a chain and how to identify it and other things. Now the first thing is root word will give us the main information regarding the number of carbon atoms that was present in the main structure of a compound, that is main chain of a compound. If number of carbon atoms present in a compound is 1, you will get meth as a root word. If number of carbon atoms are 2, you will get eth as a root word. If number of carbon atoms are 3, you will get prope as a root word. If number of carbon atoms are 4, bute. Number of carbon atoms are 5, pent. Now, primary suffix. This primary suffix will explain us about the nature of the hydrocarbon in which, by which this organic compound is formed. Almost all organic compounds are found to be the derivatives of hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbon means a compound which contains only carbon and hydrogen are said to be hydrocarbon. We have already discussed in the previous classes about the hybridization of carbon, where it can take three types of hybridizations: sp3 hybridization, sp2 hybridization, and sp hybridization. If almost all carbon atoms in the compound are involved in sp3 hybridization, such hydrocarbons are called as alkanes. Such hydrocarbons are called as alkanes. If minimum 2 carbon atoms are involved in sp2 hybridization, that is, if double bond is present in between 2 carbon atoms, and they are said to be alkenes. If 2 carbon atoms are involved in sp hybridization, then those hydrocarbons are said to be alkynes. So now almost all, each and every organic compound may belongs mainly from these three categories, or derivative of these three categories. The compound may be alkane, or compound may be alkene, or compound may be alkyne. It belongs to any one of these three categories. Once again, I'll explain you. If the compounds are involved in sp3 hybridization, they are said to be alkanes. If all carbon atoms are involved in sp3 hybridization, then that compound is said to be alkane. If 2 carbon atoms are in sp2 hybridization, then it is said to be alkene. If 2 carbon atoms are in sp hybridization, they are said to be alkynes. So these three hybridizations, just before two classes we discussed about these three hybridizations. So if all carbon atoms are involved in sp3 hybridization, you will have only single bond between carbon and carbon. All carbon atoms, they won't form any pi bonds. They will form only sigma bonds. If 2 carbon atoms are present in a compound with sp2 hybridization, then there will be a double bond between 2 carbon atoms. If 2 carbon atoms are involved in sp hybridization, then you will have a triple bond between 2 carbon atoms. Then if triple bond is there, they are said to be alkynes. If double bond is there, they are said to be alkenes. And all are single bonds, then they are said to be alkynes. Now this ane, ene, ine, ane, ene, yne will add to the root word as a primary suffix. Add to the root word as a primary suffix. For example, here I am taking a compound which contains three carbon atoms. CH3, CH2, CH3. So here we have three carbon atoms in this compound. So the root word according to three is prop. So the name of this compound is prop plus, since all are single bonds, as a primary suffix we have ane. So name of this compound is propane. Name of the compound is propane. If two carbon atoms are involved in double bond, so when double bond is there, it means there are one pi bond and one sigma bond. That means two carbon atoms are involved in sp2 hybridization. So if it is involved in sp2 hybridization, it is under the category of alkene. So root word is prop plus ene. So the name of this compound is propene. Name of this compound is propene. Here the name of the compound is propane. Here it is propene. If two carbon atoms are involved in sp hybridization like this, now here we have three carbon atoms, so root word is prop, and since triple bond is there, as a primary suffix we will have yne. So the name of this compound is propyne. Name of this compound is propyne. Let us discuss another example. Here we have another compound. Here in this compound we have 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atoms are there. So the root word is bute. Now all are single bonds. In between carbon atoms we have only single bonds. So here it is alkane. Bute plus ane. So the name of this compound is butane. Name of the compound is butane. Now another compound, CH3, CH2, CH, double bond, CH2. Now here we have a double bond. That means these two carbon atoms are involved in sp2 hybridization. So it is under the class of alkenes. So the name of this compound is 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbon atoms are there. So root word is bute. Since it is alkene plus ene, butene. Here you have remember that this bond may present here also with the same formula. Now here if you number 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 carbon atoms are there, and now this bond is in between 1 and 2 carbon atoms. So since it is 1 and 2 carbon atoms, you have to mention the position of the double bond also. So to give that clarity, this one, it means since it is in between 1 and 2, this butene actual name we have to pronounce is bute. One ene. Bute one in, or you can say one butene. Bute one in or bute one butene. Suppose if this double bond is present here, now here 1, 2, 3, 4. Now this bond is in between 2 and 3. Suppose if you number from this side also, it is 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can number the compounds from any side. So here it is in between 2, 3, and it here also it is 2, 3. So name of this compound is bute plus 2 plus ene. That means bute 2 ene. The name of this compound is bute 2 ene, or you may say 2 butene. Now secondary suffix. So now, so far we have discussed about root word and primary suffix. Now I am going to discuss about this secondary suffix. In secondary suffix, we have to mention the functional group that was involved in the compound. Functional group, what is a functional group? In organic compounds, we have other elements also present in it. Because of the presence of those atoms or the group of atoms, the properties of that organic compound is completely changes. So the group which is root cause for the properties of that compound is said to be a functional group. In the classification of organic compounds, we have already discussed about these things as heteroatomic compounds. So the important functional groups are OH, they are said to be alcohols. OH group is said to be alcohols. In IUPAC system, we have to add OL for such compounds as a secondary suffix. CHO group is said to be aldehydes. We have to add AL for such compounds as a secondary suffix. If C double bond O is present, they are said to be ketones. So now we have to add ONE as a secondary suffix. If COOH group is present, they are said to be carboxylic acids. We have to add oic acid as a secondary suffix. COOR are said to be esters. We have to mention them as OH as a secondary suffix. If CN group, cyanide group is present, they are said to be nitriles. We have to add nitrile as a secondary suffix, and so on. Because of the presence of this group, the properties of entirely changed. Suppose if a carbon chain contains 200 carbon atoms, by the replacement of one hydrogen with this group, are two hydrogens with this group, the entire properties of the compound will changes. The whole properties of these compounds will depend upon this group. That's why this group is said to be a functional group. So if functional group is present in a compound, that functional group should be mentioned as a secondary suffix in the name of an organic compound. Let us verify some examples. Here we have four carbon atoms and all are single bonds. So four carbon atoms is there, so it is butte. All are single bonds, so we can say it as a butane. In this butane, in place of one hydrogen, here previously three hydrogens are there, one hydrogen was replaced and OH group was added here. Now since the OH group is present, the properties of this compound is completely changes because of the single group. This group is said to be a functional group. The compounds which contain this OH group are considered as alcohols. They are considered as alcohols. Now here in butane, one hydrogen was replaced by one OH group. Since it is butane, when OH group is there, we can call them as butyl alcohol. That will be a common name. For IUPAC system, we have a procedure, that is root word, primary suffix and secondary suffix. Now since here four carbon atoms are there, root word is bute. Since all are involved in sp3 hybridization and they are involved in the single bond formation, so ANE. Now in place of this E in the primary suffix, we have to add OL to it. In place of E, we have to add OL. So it is called as butanol. It is called as butanol. Since it is in the first carbon, we need not mention the position of that OH group. Suppose if it was present in the second carbon, CH3, now we can say it as 2-butanol or butan-2-ol. Butan-2-ol. Now, now here there is a double bond and there is a OH group. So here we have two functional groups because the double bond and triple bond can also be considered as functional groups. So now OH group is present in the first place, first carbon, and in between second and third carbons we have a double bond. So it is butte. Double bond is there, so it is butene. Root word is bute plus ene. In place of ene, because here all are single bonds, we add ANE. Here we have one double bond, so we are adding ENE. So in ENE, in place of this E, we have to add this ol. And this ol is in the first carbon. So we have to mention that also. Ene in the second carbon. So bute 2 ene 1 ol. Bute 2 ene 1 ol is the name of this compound. Here we have another compound.
In this compound, we have OH group and a triple bond. We have OH group and triple bond. So it is alkyne with alcohol group. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So here triple bond is present in between second and third carbon, and OH group was present at the first carbon. So while naming the compound, first count the number of carbon atoms present in it. The number of carbon atoms are 4. So but is the root word. Since triple bond is there, primary suffix is YNE, and OH group is there, in place of E you have to add ol. And this OH group is in the first carbon and triple bond is in the second carbon. So the name of this compound is but-2-ine-1-ol. But-2-ine-1-ol is the name of that organic compound. Now let us verify another compound. So here we have a compound which is having functional group CHO. When CHO is there, they are considered as aldehydes. And here in this carbon, you have to number this as 1, 2, 3, 4. Now there is a double bond between second and third carbon. Number of carbon atoms are 4. Number of carbon atoms are 4. So the root word is but. And double bond is there. Ene, butene. But one functional group is there. So you have to mention this functional group. By replacing small e here, you have to add al. That means it is butenol. If it is alcohol, butenol. But here it is butenol. But you have to mention the position of this double bond, because you need not mention the position, because aldehyde position, carbon position, CHO group position is always number 1. So you need not mention it specially. It always considers the first carbon. So ene double bond is present in second and third carbons. So but 2-enol. But 2-enol is the name of that organic compound. But 2-enol. So this is the way to use this root word, primary suffix and secondary suffix. So the root word mainly gives us the information regarding the number of carbon atoms that are present in the compound. And primary suffix will give us information when this category belongs to alkane or alkene or alkyne. And the secondary suffix will explain us regarding a special functional groups other than this double bond and triple bond that were present in the compound. So each of them will have a special secondary suffixes. They are, if they are alcohols, we have to add ol. If they are aldehydes, we have to add al. If they are ketones, we have to add one, one. If they are carboxylic acids, you have to add oic acid. If they are esters, you have to add oate. If they are cyanide compounds, you have to add nitrile. And so on. For each functional group, there is a specific secondary suffix which has to be added to it. So now we have completed the 3 parts that are present in the name of an organic compound. Now let us finally study about this prefix. What is prefix? Here we have a compound. Because in the most of the organic compounds, we have these branches, side chains. So many groups may be attached to the main chain. So here if you observe this compound, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,
6 carbon atoms are there. Previously we discussed that root word will give us the number of carbon atoms. But here you cannot say that 6 carbon atoms are there, you cannot claim it as a hexane. Because they are not in a straight chain, they present as branches. So, you should mention those branches as a substituents. So, you should mention them as a prefix. You should mention them as a prefix. So, this prefix will inform us or explains us about the branches or side chains or the substituents that were attached to the main carbon chain. So, while selecting a main carbon chain, there are certain rules, we will discuss it later. But since it is a simple compound, you need not worry about such rules. First, let us see, this can be taken as a main chain, or this can also be taken as a main chain, or this can also be taken as a main chain, it makes no difference. So, for convenience, let us take this as a main chain, because in any direction you are going to get only 5 carbon atoms. So, this is taken as a main chain. So, now you have to consider the carbon atoms that were present in the main chain only as a root word. You should exclude these 2 carbons. In main chain you have 4 carbon atoms. So, the root word is butte. In this main chain all are single bonds. So, ANE. Here OH group is there. So, you have to add OL. Replace E and add OL. Now, root word is completed. Primary suffix was completed. Secondary suffix was completed. The remaining thing is these substituents. We should mention them as prefixes. So, these prefixes, according to this numbering, they are present at 3rd carbon. Since 2 similar groups are there, so they are the derivatives of methane. CH4 is methane. Methane. So, here we have CH3. That means one hydrogen, in place of one hydrogen, this chain was attached here. So, this CH3 is said to be methyl. That means for a root word, you have to add YL, methyl. If it is ethane, ethyl. If it is propane, propyl. If it is butane, butyl. Pentane, pentyl, pentanyl, hexanyl, heptanyl, octanyl. You have to add YL. Suppose if it is alkene, ethenyl, propenyl, butenyl, pentenyl, hexenyl, heptenyl. Alkyne, same. Ethyanyl, propynyl, propynyl, butynyl. You have to add like that. So, here 2 methyl groups are present here, and these 2 methyl groups are at 3rd carbon. So, you mentioned that carbon number of the carbon in which they are substituted. So, we have to write this name as 3,3-dimethyl 2,2-dimethyl plus butte plus ane plus ol. So, the complete name of this compound is 3,3-dimethyl butanol. 3,3-dimethyl butanol, 3,3-dimethyl butanol, or 3,3-dimethyl butane 1-ol, or 1-butanol. Because if it is in the first carbon, generally we need not mention it. If it is in the second or third carbons, then specifically we have to mention that name. Suppose if these two methyl groups are present in two carbon atoms like this, so first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon. So two methyls. Here two methyl groups are in one carbon only. Now here in the second carbon and this is in the third carbon. So now the name of this compound is 2,3-dimethylbutanone. 2,3-dimethylbutanone. So this is the way we have to write an organic compound. Now, in the next class, we'll discuss the selection of the main chain and the rest of the things, and rest of the rules are